弟兄姊妹平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
感谢主，我们今天可以一同来学习神的话。
We thank the Lord that today we can come together to learn about the Word of God.
今天我们一同来学习路德记第四章的第一节到第十节。
So today let us come to learn about the passage in the book of Ruth, chapter 4, verses 1 through 10.
路德记第四章的第一节到第十节。
The book of Ruth, chapter 4, verses 1 through 10.
我们一同把这段经文来读一遍。您在电脑前可以用您自己倾向的语言来读。
Let's all read together in this passage, and you can read with your preferred language by yourself.
路德记第四章，伯阿斯到了城门，坐在那里，恰巧伯阿斯所说的那致敬的亲属经过。伯阿斯说，某人呐，你来坐在这里。他就来坐下。伯阿斯又从本城的长老中拣选了十人，对他们说，请你们坐在这里。他们就都坐下。伯阿斯对那致敬的亲属说，从摩押地回来的拿阿米，现在要卖我们族兄以利米勒的那块地。我想当属那块地的是你，其次是我，以外再没有别人了。你可以在这里的人面前和我本国的长老面前说明，你若肯赎就赎，若不肯赎就告诉我。那人回答，我肯赎。伯阿斯说，你从拿阿米手中买这地的时候，也当娶死人的妻摩雅女子路德，使死人在产业上存留他的名。那人说，这样我就不能赎了，恐怕与我的产业有碍。你可以赎我所当赎的，我不能赎了。从前在以色列中要定夺什么事，或赎回或交易，这人就托写给那人，以色列人都以此为证据。那人对伯阿斯说，你自己买吧。于是将鞋脱下来了。伯阿斯对长老和众民说，你们今日做见证，凡属以利米勒和基连马伦的，我都从拿阿米手中置买了，又娶了马伦的妻摩雅女子路德为妻，好在死人的产业上存留他的名，免得他的名在本族本乡灭没。你们今日可以做见证。好，我们一起低头有一点祷告。
Let us bow our heads and pray.
主，我们满心的感谢你。
Lord, we come and our hearts are filled with thanksgiving.
因为我们知道你的话就是我们生命的粮食。
Because we know that your word is the food of our life.
你的话也是我们脚前的灯和路上的光。
And that your words are the lamp of my feet and light of my path.
而且你是那位乐意向你的百姓施恩的主。
And that you are the Lord who is who takes pleasure in giving grace to your people.
我们实在是求圣灵来帮助我们。
We truly ask the Holy Spirit to come and help us.
把你的话语向我们打开。
To open up your words to us.
让我们讲的、翻译的和听的，让我们一同在你的跟前被造就。
So that the speaker, the translator, and the listeners may be edified in front of you.
我们这样的祷告是靠主耶稣基督的名。
We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
今天我们读的这段故事是路德记最后一章。
So today, the passage that we read about, we are reading about, is the last chapter of the book of Ruth.
路德记前面的故事充满了惊奇、转折和悬念。
So all of the stories that happened before, it's filled with twists and turns and amazements.
原本幸福美满的一家人非要离开迦南地去摩亚地。
So originally a family who's very well off, they wanted to leave the land of Canaan and go into the land of Moab.
最后的是家破人亡。
And the end result is people died and it basically destroyed their family.
没办法，剩下的人只能灰头土脸的回到伯利恒。
And whoever is left, they had no choice but to return in sadness, in misery, back to Bethlehem.
然而就在他们 最低谷的时候，他们遇到了这座城里面既富有又良善的大财主。
However, when they are in the midst of the deepest valley of their lives, they met this noble man, this wealthy man, Boaz.
而且这个大财主非常的欣赏路德。
And this noble and wealthy man truly admired Ruth.
就好像是一个王子和一个灰姑娘一样。
It's as if it's the Cinderella story, you know, a prince and Cinderella.
王子和灰姑娘他们如果要想走到一起，可以说是困难重重。
For the prince and Cinderella to come together, that path is filled with difficulties.
因为这两个人他们的阶级地位文化背景差距太大了。
Because their background, their culture, their tradition, their stature in society, it's so different.
然而这一切在人看来不可能的障碍，因着伯阿斯的恩典都一一的被克服了。
However, all these obstacles that seem to be impossible to overcome in men's eyes, because of the appearance of Boaz, they're all resolved.
可是还有最后一个难处。
But there's the last obstacle they have to overcome.
就是按照律法呀，伯阿斯他不是第一顺位可以拯救路德他们家的。
So that is, according to the law, Boaz is not the first in line to redeem the family.
离伯阿斯名正言顺的迎娶路德还差最后的一步。
There is still one last step before Boaz can marry Ruth.
就是另外一个比伯阿斯更近的至近的亲属需要放弃自己救赎的义务。
Which is that there is even a closer kinsman redeemer than Boaz, and that closer relative, he needs to give up his right to redeem.
伯阿斯如何的把救赎的这件事情办成，就是今天这段经文的主要的内容。
So how does Boaz accomplish this work of salvation? This is the central point of today's passage.
我们先来看第一节经文。
Let's take a look at verse 1.
伯阿斯到了城门，坐在那里。恰巧伯阿斯所说的那至近的亲属经过。伯阿斯说：“某人呐，你来坐在这里。”他就坐下。
So meanwhile, Boaz, verse 1, meanwhile, Boaz went up to the town gate and sat there when the kinsman redeemer he had mentioned came along. And Boaz said, come over here, my friend, and sit down. So he went over and sat down.
这节经文的第一个词是 meanwhile, 与此同时。
So the very first word of this passage, of this verse is meanwhile.
就说明现在这件事情和第三章的末了，路德和拿俄米在商议，这两件事情是同时进行的。
So this means that, if we look back to the end of chapter 3, while Naomi and Ruth, they're talking about this matter, this is happening at the same time in parallel.
有意思的是，拿俄米和路德他们都没有告诉伯阿斯，你要在什么时候，你要在什么时间，你要在哪里做什么事情。
What's interesting is that neither Naomi nor Ruth was told Boaz what to do, when to do, where to do this.
这一系列的都是伯阿斯他主动要做成的救赎的工作。
All of these actions, they are all actions, proactive actions by Boaz he himself to accomplish this work of salvation.
而且是今天早上立刻马上就去办。
And it is this morning, immediately, he went and started doing it.
这里我们就看到这位伯阿斯他不单言，他不误事。
So here we can see that this Boaz, he doesn't procrastinate, he doesn't delay this thing.
他是一位乐意施恩的主，他也不会违背他昨天对着路德的诺言。
He is the Lord that's willing and pleasing, it's pleasing to him to give grace. And he will not break the promise that he already gave to Ruth last night.
第一节这里一开始就讲到伯阿斯到了城门。
So verse 1, it says, Boaz came to the town gate.
城门是当时人们进出城办事的必经之地。
So the town gate is the gate where all the townspeople, when they need to go out to do business, they have to pass through that gate.
城门不仅是一扇门，它是整个的一个塔状的建筑。
So, the town gate is not just the door, but it's a tower.
在城门的两侧有一些的房间，这些房间是当时城里人做出重大决策的地方。
So right next to the gate, there are some small rooms, and those rooms are where important decisions are made with the townspeople.
就相当于是这个城门，就相当于是我们今天的市政厅。
So if you look at it, it's just like our municipality hall of modern times.
当博阿斯到了城门的时候，恰巧博阿斯所说的那至近的亲属经过。
So when Boaz came to the town's gate, behold, this kinsman redeemer came along.
第一节这里所讲的这个恰巧啊，是路德记里面的第三次恰巧。
So here, this translation of coincidence, or in English, it's called behold. This is the third time that in the book of Ruth that's mentioned about it.
路德曾经恰巧到了博阿斯的田里面。博阿斯也曾经恰巧从伯利恒回到他的田，这两个人当时就碰上了。
So Ruth, she happened to come into the field of Boaz, and Boaz, he happened to just came back to Bethlehem into his field before.
今天博阿斯又恰巧碰到了至近的亲属。
And today, it happens to be, or behold, that this kinsman redeemer is here.
这至近的亲属恰巧就是博阿斯要找的那个人。
And this person, this kinsman redeemer, is just happens to be the person that Boaz wants to meet.
在我们基督徒的生命里面也有很多的恰巧。
So in our lives, in Christian lives, there are a lot of seems to be coincidences.
你恰巧碰到了一位基督徒，你恰巧听到了福音，你恰巧得到了一份工作，你恰巧到了一群弟兄姊妹的中间。
For example, you happen to meet another Christian, you happen to find another job, you happen to come into the midst of brothers and sisters.
好像是因为我们运气好。
It seems like we're just being, it's fortunate, it's luck, it's luck.
其实在这一切恰巧的背后，都是神的那双无形的手在那里安排，在那里掌管。
But in all of these happens to be, all these coincidences, there's God's hand behind everything.
换句话讲，在我们基督徒的生命中是没有偶然的。
So in other words, in Christian lives, there's really nothing of coincidence.
每一件事，无论是好事坏事，无论顺境逆境，都是神在那里调度。在那里掌权。
Everything, no matter if it's positive or negative, it is all governed, controlled by God.
都是神在那里让万事互相效力。
It's through God that He is making all things to work together.
那这里很有意思的一点就是，这一位至近的亲属啊，我们知道这个人啊，他是不要神、背逆神的。
So what's interesting is that This close kinsman redeemer, he's someone who doesn't want God.
然而就是这样一个不要神、背逆神的人，他都要乖乖的在某个时刻出现在某个特定的地方。
However, even with a person like this, that he is going away and against God, but God can still use him in this incident.
恰巧那个地方就是博阿斯刚刚坐下的地方。
That it happens to be that that's the place where he passed by, that's where Boaz is sitting.
第一节的末了，博阿斯说，某人呢，你来坐在这里，他就来坐下。
And here it says that, come over so-and-so and sit down. So he went over and sat down.
这里很奇怪的。
It's really strange here.
因为博阿斯既然知道这个人是至近的亲属，既然能够从人群中认出他，说明博阿斯肯定知道这个人的名字。
Because Boaz, if he can recognize this person from all these people, he knows about him, he definitely knows his name.
然而，圣灵在记录这个故事的时候啊，却把这个人记成某人啊，翻译过来就是 Mr. So and So。
But when the Holy Spirit records this incident down, he's just calling this person's name to be so and so.
啊，总之就这个人没有名字。
So in other words, this person has no name.
啊，这是很有意思的一件事情。
This is something really interesting.
在路德记的第四章里面有许许多多的人物。
So in chapter 4 of the book of Ruth, there are many different characters.
啊，特别是我们今天读这一段啊，每个人都有名字的。
Especially the passage that we read today, every person has a name.
啊，外邦人有名字。
The Gentile has a name.
啊，死到外邦的以色列人也有名字。
The person that the Israelite that died in the Gentile land, he had a name.
唯独这里的这个某人呀，这个以色列的这个至亲的亲属，他是没有名字的。
It's only this person, this Israelite kinsman redeemer, he had no name.
圣灵为什么故意的不记下这个人的名字呢？
So why is it that the Holy Spirit purposely omitted his name?
我们先看接下来这个故事的发展，希望我们读到后面的时候，弟兄姊妹，你们可以得到一个你们的答案。
So let's continue to see the development of this passage. And later on, brothers and sisters, you can see what the answer is.
第二节，伯阿斯又从本城的长老中拣选了十人，对他们说，请你们坐在这里，他们就都坐下。
So Boaz took 10 of the elders of the town and said, sit here, and they did so.
伯阿斯不仅找到了要做交易的某人，他也找来了十个长老作为见证人。
So Boaz not only found the person, the so-and-so that was going to come and redeem, but also found these 10 elders.
这些见证人他们要来见证伯阿斯和某人的这个交易。
And these elders are here to testify, to witness this dealing that's about to happen.
他们要见证这个交易的公平、自愿、合法。
So they need to witness the justification of this dealing that, and also this whether or not this deal abides by the law.
一旦达成协议，就说好了，以后就不能改了。
Once they reach an agreement, then you cannot change it anymore.
伯阿斯是这个会议的主持者，他也是整个交易的发起者。
So.Boaz is basically the master of ceremony of this whole dealing, and he is also the initiator of this deal.
Boaz, 他要在公开的场合，在长老们的见证下，按照神的律法来办成这件赎买的事情。
So Boaz, under the law, under the witness of the elders, he is going to accomplish this matter of redeeming.
我们这里要停下来想一想，伯阿斯他可不可以不这么干
？We need to pause a little bit and think about it. Is it possible for Boaz not to do it this way?
你想，他和路德两个人，一个愿意娶，一个愿意嫁。
Think about it. So he and Ruth, one is willing to marry him, and he is willing to marry her.
为什么要把这个事情搞得这么麻烦呢？
Why is it that he needs to bother with so much and do it so, you know, so in a complicated way?
何况在士师记的那个时代，没有人在乎神的律法的。
And also in that age of judges, no one really cares about the law of God.
这里我们看到，在伯阿斯身上有一个很重要的品格。
So here we see a very important quality or character of Boaz.
就是伯阿斯啊，他非常的珍惜每一个可以遵守神律法的机会。
And that is Boaz, he truly treasures every opportunity that he has to abide by the law of God.
弟兄们，弟兄姊妹们，什么人会喜爱每一个遵守神律法的机会呢？
So brother and sister, what kind of person will be willing or take joy in abiding by the law of God at every opportunity.
我们罪人是巴不得没有律法的，罪人是喜欢无法无天的。
You know, sinners, they really hope for lawlessness.
只有里面圣洁的人，只有里面满了基督耶稣生命的人，才可能喜爱耶和华的律法。
It is only the person that is filled with the holiness, with the holiness of the Lord Jesus Christ, this person will be willing to abide by the law of God.
也只有这样的人才可能愿意活出律法的生活。
And only such a person that's willing to live out a life that's abiding by the law of God.
所以这里我们看到啊，这位伯阿斯啊，他就是我们主耶稣基督的预表。
So here we can see that Boaz is truly a representation of our Lord Jesus.
伯阿斯在这里所要成就的这个救赎的工作，他就是一副主耶稣救赎工作的那个画面。
So the Boaz, the work of salvation, of redeeming that Boaz here is doing, is just like the work of salvation, of redeeming by our Lord Jesus Christ.
接下来的第三节到第八节，我们就看到在长老们的见证下，整个交易的过程。
Then through verses 3 through 8, you can see by the testimony of the elders, what the development, what the process is of this redeeming.
波阿斯先陈述了一个要求在第三节那里。
So verse 3, Boaz first described this demand.
波阿斯对那致敬的亲属说，从摩押地回来的拿阿米，现在要卖我们族兄以利米勒的那块地。
Then he said to the Redeemer, Naomi, who has come back from the county of Moab, is selling the parcel of land that belonged to our relative Elimelech.
我们读到这里可以来思考一下。
So when we read to this part, let's think about it.
是谁在卖地？
Who is selling this parcel of land?
是拿米在卖地，对不对？
It's Naomi that's selling the land, right?
如果拿阿米在卖地，那为什么拿阿米不出来卖，而是波阿斯来帮他卖？
If Naomi is the seller, then how come Naomi is not here, but instead Boaz is the person that's selling for her?
而且前面的故事里面，波阿斯和拿阿米是从来没有说过话的。
And in the story before, you don't see, Naomi never and Boaz they never spoke to each other.
这个卖地的这个事情是直接关系到。拿俄米和路德的命运呢，直接关系到以利米勒家族的存留的。
The selling of the land is directly related to the future of Naomi and Ruth. It's directly related to the family of Elimelech.
这么重要的剧情啊，没有以利米勒家人的参与，却都是伯阿斯独自一个人去完成的。
Such an important part.You see no participant from the family of Elimelech or Ruth or Naomi participating here.
伯阿斯去到城门口啊，伯阿斯坐下，伯阿斯找到致敬的亲属。
So Boaz went to the town gate. Boaz sat down. Boaz found the kinsman redeemer.
啊，伯阿斯召集整个陪审团的长老啊，接下来我们看到伯阿斯他的申诉。他的辩护最后是伯阿斯的宣告。
So Boaz here found the witnesses, Boaz proclaimed, Boaz did all of these things.
整个救赎的工作都是伯阿斯一个人来完成的。
The entire work of salvation, of redeeming, is accomplished by Boaz himself.
在整个这个交易的过程中啊，伯阿斯他既像是主持的法官，又好像是一个律师。
So in this entire dealing, it feels like he is the judge, but he is also the lawyer.
他用非常专业的语言来为拿阿米做辩护啊，他就是那个拿阿米的辩护律师，他代表拿阿米来做交易。
He is using very professional terms to defend Naomi. He is serving as the defending attorney for Naomi.
这里我们看到啊，这位伯阿斯他真的是好像我们的主耶稣。
So here you can see Boaz. He's just like our Lord Jesus.
我们这些曾经享受罪中之乐的人，我们是从来没有求过主耶稣的，你来帮帮忙，你来解决我们罪恶的问题。
All of us who are enjoying in sins and transgressions, we never ask Jesus to come and help us.
是我们的主，他一个人早早的在十字架上成就了救赎的工作，并且把一切的恩典当作礼物送给我们。
It is our Lord. He very early on already accomplished this salvation on the cross, and gave it to us, and he accomplished the work.
而且我们的主他不但一个人成就了所有救赎的工作，我们的主他也是我们的辩护律师。
And not only did our Lord accomplish all these things himself, but he is also our defending attorney.
堕落的罪人哪里有胆量去到圣洁公义的神面前去求情？
This fallen man, such as us, we don't dare to come to this righteous God to come to him.
但是在神那里，我们有一位中保，就是我们的主耶稣基督，他在父神那里为我们求情。
But here in front of our Lord, we have this Lord Jesus who is propitiating for us in front of God.
魔鬼拼命的指控我们，你看这些人，他们虚伪，他们肮脏。
Satan continuously accuses us and say, look at them. These people are unclean. They are hypocrites.
我们的主他一次献上，就把我们失去的产业，把我们失去的身份，把我们失去的荣耀买赎回来给我们。
But our Lord, with his one sacrificing once, he redeems all of those things that we have lost.
我们的主他一个人成就了所有救赎的工作。
That our Lord, he himself, he has accomplished all of the work of salvation.
伯阿斯在这里也是的，他一个人来成就所有的救赎的工作。
And just like Boaz here, he himself, he accomplished all of these work, all of this work of salvation.
第三节后半句，伯阿斯继续讲说，从摩阿地回来的拿阿米，现在要卖我们族兄以利米勒的那块地。
The latter portion of verse 3 says, Naomi, who has come back from the country of Moab, is selling the parcel of land that belonged to our relative Elimelech.
那块地是以色列人称呼一块土地的一个专业术语。
So that parcel of land is a professional term to describe a piece of land.
是讲到这块地的主权是单单属于耶和华的。
It means that the sovereignty of that land, that sovereignty belongs to Lord Jehovah.
以色列百姓所拥有的只不过是这块土地的使用权。
What the Israelites has towards that land is only the right to use it.
这里讲到这块那块地啊，曾经是以利米勒所他所有拥有那个使用权的。
Here it says that's the parcel of land that belonged to our relative Elimelech.
以利米勒这个名字，它是路德记第一章开头提到的第一个名字。
So Elimelech is the name that was mentioned at the first name that was mentioned in the first chapter of Book of Ruth.
也是路德记所记录的第一个死人的名字。
And also, this is the first name of the first dead person that was recorded in the book of Ruth.
这个死人的名字在最后一章再一次出现。
So this dead person's name appeared once again in the last chapter.
就是说，这一个死在罪恶过犯中的人啊，他的产业能否存留，就看这些救赎主他愿不愿意。
So it means that whether or not this person who died in sins and transgression, this parcel of land that belongs to him, whether or not that can be redeemed, now is all in the hands of this Redeemer.
现在这里的这个某人啊，因为他是以利米勒至近的亲属，所以他有第一顺位的救赎的义务。
So now this Mr. So-and-so, he is the first in line kinsman Redeemer to redeem.
所以现在的问题就是他愿不愿意帮助拿阿米。
So now the question is whether or not he's willing to help out Naomi.
第四节 啊，伯阿斯继续像一个律师一样，要给这个某人解释的清清楚楚。
So verse 4, Boaz, just like an attorney, he is here to explain very clearly to this kinsman redeemer.
我想第四节啊，我想当赎那块地的是你，其次是我，以外再没有别人了。
He said, so I thought I will tell you of it and say, if you will redeem it. But if you will not, then tell me, then I will do it.
那就是现在就我们两个人有资格来赎买，因为我们跟他们家有血缘的关系，因为我们有赎买的能力。但是呢，你比我有优先的次序，所以你先选。
So it's basically saying it, now it's just the two of us because we are blood relatives with them. And if now it comes down to the two of us. If you're not willing to do it, then I will do it.
第四节中间这里他说，你若肯赎就赎，若不肯赎就告诉我。
It says, if you will redeem it. But if you will not, tell me.
弟兄姊妹，假如你没有读第四节的最后那三个字儿，我们读到第四节的中间，你期待那个某人啊，他怎么回答
？So, brothers and sisters, if you did not come to read the end of verse 4, how would you, what would you rather, this kinsman redeemer, to respond?
假如我们再看那个路德记的这个电影啊，我前面伯阿斯和路德他们经历过了那么多的曲折和坎坷。所有人都期待着伯阿斯和路德他们最后能够走到一起。
So if you watch the movie of the book of Ruth here, if you see all of the troubles and tribulations that Ruth and Naomi has experienced, you all hope that they will have a good result and that Ruth and Boaz will come together in the end, right?
所以我们都期待那个某人他应该说什么，他应该说我不要。然后伯阿斯顺理成章的就接盘了，然后我们就放心了。
So we all hope that this closer kinsman redeemer will say, no, I will not redeem it. Then that means Ruth and Boaz will come together.
然而第四节的末了，那人回答说，我肯赎。
However, at the end of verse 4, that person said, I will redeem it.
你读到这里完了，半路杀出来个第三者。
So here you think, oh, all is gone. Now there's this third person that came out in the middle.
这个时候你会不会替路德紧张呀？
So now would you be nervous for Ruth?
假如现在有人把这一幕用手机直播给路德看，路德一看，那个人说他肯赎啊，估计这个路德脸都绿了。
So if Ruth can watch a live broadcast on the cell phone of what's happening, maybe Ruth will just be really disappointed, right?
这个时候啊，伯阿斯非常淡定的陈述着这个救赎主接下来要尽的第二个义务。
So now Boaz said in a very calm manner on what the second portion of obligation that the kinsman redeemer must do.
伯阿斯说，你从拿阿米手中买这地的时候，也当娶死人的妻摩亚女子路德，使死人在产业上存留他的名。
Then Boaz said, the day you buy the field from the hand of Naomi, you also acquire Ruth the Moabite, the widow of the dead, in order to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance.
第五节伯阿斯这里的意思就是说呀，你想买地可以，同时你必须娶摩亚女子路德。
So verse 5 basically means that, yeah, you can purchase this land. However, at the same time, you must also acquire Ruth the Moabite.
伯阿斯提出的这个条件是有原因的。
There's a reason for Boaz to come up with this condition.
我们来复习一下这个故事的背景。
So let's review a little bit of the background of this story.
就是以利米勒家已经没有男人了，拿阿米已经不能生育了，他们这家没有后代来继承产业了。
So the house of Elimelech, he had no more offspring. to continue to inherit all this possession.
这对犹太人而言就是表示这家他们从神的应许里面消失了。
So to the Jewish people, it means that this entire family will disappear in front of God.
现在这家人唯一的一线希望就是路德可以嫁给至敬的亲属，生一个男孩子，让死人的名字可以被存留。
So now the only hope is that Ruth can marry someone and to have a boy, a son, so that this name of Elimelech can continue on.
伯阿斯这里所提出的这个方案本身就是神在律法里面所设立的一个制度。
So Boaz, this plan of Boaz that he came out of is actually a law given by God.
就是至敬的亲属啊，他有义务去娶死人的死去的弟兄的妻子，然后生孩子，让死人的名可以存留，可以被纪念。
Which is this kinsman redeemer, he has an obligation to marry the wife of his brother so that the name of his brother's household can continue on, can be perpetuated.
至敬的亲属，他有义务去赎买土地，帮助弟兄的家里面解决经济上的困难。
This kinsman redeemer has an obligation to redeem back this land so that economically, financially, his close relatives' family can be supported.
神设立救赎主的制度啊，是因为神知道人会犯罪，人会失败，人会软弱。
God, for him to establish this law of redeemer, is that he knows man will fail, man's weak, man will sin.
所以他就设立了这个救赎主的制度让浪子可以有回头的机会让无依无靠的人可以有家可回。
Therefore, he established this system so that the prodigal son can return, so that there is a chance for them to be redeemed.
以利米勒的儿子他是一个失败的人。
So the son of Elimelech, they were failures.
然而神的恩典可以大过人的软弱。
But God's grace is bigger than the weaknesses of men.
让曾经死在罪恶过犯中的人可以有机会被神纪念。
The person who died in sin and transgression can now be remembered by God.
那谁是那一位有恩典的救赎主呢？
So who is that gracious redeemer?
这位至敬的亲属，他愿不愿意顺服神所设立的这个制度，让神的心意成全呢？
So this kinsman redeemer, is he willing to abide by the will of God and so that the will of God can be accomplished?
第六节，那人说，这样我就不能赎了，恐怕与我的产业有碍。你可以赎我所当赎的，我不能赎了，恐怕与我的产业有碍。
Verse 6, it says, Then the Redeemer said, I cannot redeem it for myself, lest I impair my own inheritance. Take my right of redemption yourself, for I cannot redeem it.
就是说这个某人啊，他听到要娶路德，所以他就放弃了救赎的义务。
So here, it's this person heard that he must marry Ruth as well. So he has given up his right to redeem.
他给的原因就是恐怕与我的产业有碍。他在这里说了两次。
The reason for him to do this is because it will impair his own inheritance. And he said it twice.
就这位至敬的亲属呀，他从经济学的角度来考量一下，他精打细算一下，发现，哎呀，我这样太不划算了。
It's this redeemer, this kinsman redeemer, from the perspective of economics, he calculated a little bit and thought, wow, this is a bad deal.
我又要娶外邦的女子，而且将来生了孩子也不是我的，而且我还要替别人养这个孩子。
Now I need to marry this Gentile woman, this the son, the 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 resulting son will not be mine, and at the same time, I need to take care of them.
对，而且他买了地嘛，到了几年还要再还给人家。
And now this land at the millennium, he will need to return back.
就是他算来算去，他发现啊，这个当救赎主啊，是个只赔不赚的事儿。
So he calculated and found out that being the redeemer is a losing deal.
那对于某人来讲，那什么情况下他可以利益最大化呢？
So to this so-and-so, under what kind of circumstance will he gain the greatest profit from this?
就是他从拿阿米的手中买地，同时拿阿米和路德必须当寡妇。
Which is, he will purchase this parcel of land from Naomi, and at the same time, both Naomi and Ruth will remain as widows.
因为一旦路德嫁人，就很可能会生孩子。一旦生了孩子，这个孩子以后就要继承以利米勒家的土地。
Because if Ruth go and marry somebody else, as long as she bears a son, then this parcel of land will return back and belong to that son in the name of Elimelech.
只要以利米勒家没有后代，这个土地以后就是某人的了，这个某人的利益就可以最大化。
As long as Elimelech has no more offspring, then this Mr. So-and-so, he will gain the greatest profit.
所以在某人的这个计划里面，路德和拿阿米必须当寡妇。
So from this Mr. So-and-so, in his plan, Naomi and Ruth must remain as widows.
所以这里我们就看到这个某人啊，他是很自私的，他没有怜悯的，他不愿意让神的律法来成全。
So here you see, this is a very selfish so-and-so. He has no mercy. He has no regard for God's law to be accomplished.
那很讽刺的就是，这个人他想尽办法要保存自己的产业，他却失去了永恒的祝福，连名字都没有。
So what's interesting is that this person, what's ironic about this is that he thought of all different ways to guard his prophet. However, in eternity, he doesn't even have a name.
在路德记的第四章里边，许多人都有名字。
So in the book of Ruth, chapter 4, many different people, they all have names.
以利米勒家的男人死在了外邦，神都记下他们的名字。
The men in the household of Elimelech, when they died in a Gentile land, they even had names recorded down.
路德是一个外邦人，神也记下他的名字。
And Ruth, she's a Moabite Gentile, and God recorded down her name.
唯独这个某人他没有名字。
But this Mr. So-and-so had no name.
他没有离开迦南地去外面放荡。
He did not forsake the land of Canaan and went out to other land.
他没有犯什么杀人放火的罪。
He did not commit sins of murder or, you know, burning down other people's houses.
他，而且神也让他很富足。
And God also allowed him to be very wealthy.
有钱有地，还是教会里面的乖宝宝。
He has the land, he is wealthy, and he's very well behaved in the church.
仅仅就是因为没有履行一个救赎的义务，神就不纪念他的名字吗？
Well, does God not remember his name just because he did not fulfill his obligation?
圣经讲得很清楚，说不怜悯就是罪，不怜悯的人要受不怜悯的审判。
So in the Bible, it says for you to have, if you do not have mercy, that itself is sin. If you do not have mercy towards others, then you will receive judgment without mercy. And we need to ask God to save us out from this circumstance.
同时我们要留意一点，就是博阿斯在这里提出来的这个方案是非常的有智慧。
At the same time, we need to pay attention. It is this plan given out by Boaz is filled with wisdom.
就博阿斯把买地的这个事情跟娶寡妇的这件事情，把这两个事情打包在一起。
It is that Boaz, he packaged together the matter of purchasing back the land and also marrying Ruth. He packaged these two things together.
这种打包处理的方式是律法上没有很清楚地讲的。
This kind of packaging together into this whole deal, it was not really clearly stated in the laws.
所以博阿斯这个处理的方式，他那个实质啊。
So how Boaz dealt with this matter, he actually planned out the essence of the law.
就是神把律法给人，不是让人去钻空子啊，不是让人趁着机会我低价买进，等寡妇死了，这个地就成我家的产业了。The
purpose of the law of God is not for people to be able to profit from this whole dealing.
神给人律法的那个精义是爱，是怜悯，是给患难中的人提供帮助和保护。The
essence of the established law by God is for people to love, is to provide this protection for those who are living in tribulation.
博阿斯的这里的这个打包处理啊，他实质上是在执行那个律法的精义。
So what Boaz is doing here when he packaged these two matters together, he is actually accomplishing the essence of the law.
耶稣在福音书里面讲，你们这假冒伪善的文士和法利赛人有祸了，因为你们讲薄荷、茴香、芹菜，献上十分之一，那律法上更重要的是，就是公义、怜悯、信实，反倒不行了。So
basically, Jesus said to the scribe and the Pharisees at that time, and said, you obey the law by the words. However, the essence of this law, you do not obey.
某人在这里啊，他干的事情就是这些法利赛人干的事情。So
this person, this Mr. So-and-so, whatever he is doing, he is basically doing just like what the Pharisees were doing.
买地，对我的产业有利，我就干。 娶路德，关系到怜悯，关系到恩典，对我的产业不利，我就不干。So
for me to buy the land because it's profiting for me, then I will do it. However, if marrying Ruth, it's going to hurt my profit, then I will not do it.
以自我为中心啊，蒙了神的祝福却不体贴神的心肠，这是非常可怕的一种光景。
It is self-centered that. In such a way that you have received the grace of God, however, you are not willing to give out grace.
这个致敬的亲属啊，他为了眼前的利益，他就放弃了救赎主的责任啊，他要保护他的产业，保护他的名字，保护他的家庭。This
kinsman redeemer, he has given up his right. He wants to protect his possession, his name.
完全的不纪念他的产业，不纪念他的名字，不纪念他的家庭。
But here, God will not remember his possession, will not remember his inheritance or his family.
接下来的第七节非常有意思，路德记的作者特意的向我们解释了整个故事背后的那个习俗。
In verse 7, it's pretty interesting, it described the author of the book of Ruth, describe the tradition at that time, the background.
第七节这么讲说，从前在以色列中要定夺什么事，或赎回，或交易，这人就脱鞋给那人，以色列人都以此为证据。It
says that now this was the custom in former times in Israel concerning redeeming and exchanging to confirm a transaction. The one drew off his sandal and gave it to the other, and this was the manner of attesting in Israel.
这句话表面上是给我们铺垫了一下这个背景的知识，是你如果仔细想的话，是细思极恐。So
this is just explaining a background of a custom at that time, but if you think of it in detail, it's pretty frightening.
因为《申命记》25章那里很清楚地告诉我们，
Because in
什么样的情况下一个人要脱鞋?
Because in Deuteronomy chapter 25, it clearly described to us under what kinds of circumstance will a person take off his sandal.
就是说有一个人他死了他没有后代。
Which is, there's a person, he died and he had no offspring.
他的弟兄就有义务要来娶他的妻,好在以色列中兴起他这个死去的弟兄的名字。
So the person's brother, the dead person's brother, should go in and take her as his wife so that the dead person's name can continue on, can be raised up.
那如果这个活着的弟兄他拒绝尽弟兄的本分的话, 本城的长老都要招那人来质问他。
Then if this person, this brother, does not wish to fulfill the obligation, then the elders of the entire city will look for people and come and gather and ask him.
人也要脱了他的鞋,吐沫在他的脸上。
And men will take that person's take off that person's shoes and spit on him.
然后, 在以色列中啊,这个人的名字就要被称为脱鞋之家。
And that person who's not willing to redeem, that person's household will now be called the house that took off his sandal.
就是说一个人他不愿意履行救赎的义务,不愿意让弟兄的名字存留在神的应许里面。
Which means that this is the person who's not willing to fulfill his obligation, who's not willing for his deceased brother's name to remain in within the Israelites.
长老们都要质问他,别人要脱他的鞋来羞辱他,这是非常丢脸,非常可耻的一件事情。
So these elders will come to rebuke him, and these other people will be here to and pull the sandal off his feet. This is something that's really a shame, shameful.
然而到了第七节这里啊,脱鞋变成了一个习俗,变成了一个交易的习惯。
However, when we come to verse 7 here in the book of Ruth, it became actually a common practice of dealing.
不愿行使 救赎的责任,被人脱鞋,这么丢人的事情,这样的一个羞耻的记号,却成了人们日常交易的习俗。
This such a sign of shame. Basically, if you're not willing to fulfill your obligation, then people will pull off the sandal off your feet. Such a shameful practice now has become common practice in business dealings.
这是那一个不要神的那个时代的人们的特征。
And this is the characteristic of the people of that time who did not want God.
上帝有律法,大家都不遵守。
God had his laws, but no one abide by it.
大家不但不遵守,不但不以为那个很丢人,反而用这种丢人的记号成为一种交易的方式。
Not only did they not abide by it, but it became such a practice that it became a common practice of business dealings.
第八节,那人对伯阿斯说,你自己买吧,于是将鞋脱下来了。Verse
8, it says, so when the Redeemer said to Boaz, buy it for yourself, he drew off his sandal.
哇,这个人脱得非常的自然。
So this person, it was so natural for him to take off his sandal.
他都不需要别人给他脱鞋,他不需要长老们来质问他,他说我主动脱鞋。He
doesn't need the elders to come to rebuke him. He doesn't need other people to take off the sandals for him.
我脱完给你,你拿好。He
proactively took it off himself and said, here you go.
整个过程啊,非常的顺其自然。
The entire process, it was so smooth, so natural.
所以这个某人啊,他不是不知道神的律法,他不是没有能力去履行神的律法。
So this person, this so-and-so, it's not that he did not know of God's laws, or he had no ability to abide by God's laws.
他什么都知道,他什么都清楚,他也从神那里蒙受了物质上的祝福,然而他故意不要神的话。 故意不要神的旨意成全。
He knew everything. He had everything. He even had the blessings of God to be able to do this, but he purposely did not obey. He purposely did not want the word, the laws of God.
长老们也没有去劝一下。
And the elders did not go and you know, say a couple more words to him.
很显然，大家都是默许的。
So obviously, everyone quietly allowed this to happen.
这就是那个时代的光景，人不要神，个人任意而行。
And this is the circumstance of that time, that in Israel, there is no God. Everyone did what was right in their own eyes.
然而也就是越是黑暗的时代，也越能彰显出来光明的价值。
But now it's the darker the age is, the more the value of light can shine through.
就是在那样的一个黑暗的时代里面，有一个普通的人，他透过普通的田园生活，他把律法的精义给活了出来。
It is at that time, the dark times, that there is this ordinary person living an ordinary life, and just by abiding by the laws of God, that he lived out the essence of the laws.
啊，这个人就是伯阿斯。
And this person is Boaz.
第九节，伯阿斯对长老和众民说：“你们今日做见证。”凡属以利米勒和基连马伦的，我都从拿阿米手中置买了。
And Boaz said, verse 9, Boaz said to the elders and all the people, you are witnesses this day that I have bought from the hand of Naomi all that belonged to Elimelech and all that belonged to Chilion and Malon.
第十节，又娶了马伦的妻摩亚女子路德为妻，好在死人的产业上存留他的名。免得他的名在本族本乡灭没，你们今日可以做见证。
Also, verse 10, also Ruth the Moabite, the widow of Malon, I have bought to be my wife, to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance, that the name of the dead may not be cut off from among his brothers and from the gate of his native place. You are witnesses this day.
波阿斯在第九节的开头说：“你们今日做见证。”在第十节的末了，他又一次讲：“你们今日做见证。”
The beginning of verse 9, Boaz said, "You are witnesses this day." At the end of verse 10, he said again, "You are witnesses this day."
再次让我们看到，波阿斯他是一天都没有耽误，他巴不得救赎的工作可以早日的成就。
So here, once again, you can see that Boaz did not delay for one day the work of redeeming, that he really hoped that this can be done as soon as possible.
伯阿斯信实地兑现了，在第三章那里他对着路德的承诺。
That Boaz faithfully kept his promise to Ruth at the end of chapter 3.
而且伯阿斯他不只买了以利米勒的地。
And Boaz not only purchased back the land of Elimelech.
以利米勒、基连、马伦的地他都买了。
And he also purchased back the land that belonged to Chilion and Malon as well.
以利米勒是路德记第一章的第一个死人。
So Elimelech is the first person that died in chapter 1 of the book of Ruth.
马伦是第二个死人，基连是第三个死人。
Malone was the second dead person, and Chilion was the third dead person.
所有这些死在罪恶过犯中的人，因着一个人救赎的恩典，他们失去的产业可以被买赎回来。
So all of these people who died in sin's transgression, because this one person's redeeming, all of the possessions are redeemed back.
不至于消失在神的应许里面。
And that they will not disappear in the promise of God.
伯阿斯这里他也特别的强调，他执行救赎的选项，还不是因为他要娶路德。
And Boaz here, he especially said that the reason for him to redeem, the main reason is not to marry Ruth.
也不是因为要帮助拿阿米一家过好日子，可以不饿肚子。
And it's not...to help out Naomi's household so that they will not go hungry.
布阿斯在这里强调第十节后半句说，好在死人的产业上存留他的名，免得他的名在本族本乡灭没。
The latter portion of verse 10 says, he did this in order to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance, that the name of the dead may, will not be cut off from among his brothers and from the gate of his native place.
这里很清楚地告诉我们，就是布阿斯他为什么愿意娶路德。
So here it clearly tells us why is it that Boaz is willing to marry Ruth.
不仅是愿意他，不仅是因为啊，他愿意对路德好。
It's not only because he's willing to be kind to Ruth.
他更愿意让神的律法可以成全。
He is even more willing to accomplish God's law.
这是一幅非常美的图画。
This is something that's very beautiful.
这也是为什么以色列的百姓他们每年在五旬节的时候都要来读路德记。
And this is why every year during Pentecost, the Israelites will come and read together the book of Ruth.
因为五旬节那天啊，是以色列人与神立约的纪念日。
Because the day of Pentecost is the day when the covenant, that they remember the covenant that was established between God and the Israelites.
他们要纪念耶和华神和他们在西乃山上所立的约。
They want to come to remember Lord Jehovah and also the law that was given down to them on Mount Sinai.
神在西乃山上所颁布的律法，一方面讲到神的心意，神与他百姓的关系。
The commandment that was given out from Mount Sinai on one hand was describing the Lord's heart towards his people.
另外一方面也讲到神的百姓有责任活出荣耀神的生活。
On another hand, it's also talking about that the people of God has the obligation to live out this glorious life.
那问题就是，以色列的百姓他们嘴巴上讲，凡耶和华所吩咐的，我们都必遵行。然而呢，他们从君王到祭司到老百姓，都做不到的。
But here the problem lies within that when the Israelites responded that all that has given we shall obey. However, from their priests, from their common people, from top on down, they cannot obey it.
路德记这本书的特别之处就在于啊，在一个叫做伯利恒的乡村里面。
The special part of the book of Ruth, what's interesting is on a small town called Bethlehem.
一个普普通通的财主在普普通通的田园生活里面，把神的律法，把神的心意栩栩如生地活了出来。
This ordinary noble person, this in his ordinary life, he actually has lived out the essence of God's laws.
他在最黑暗、最败坏的时代里面，活出了最美丽的律法的生活。
That in the darkest time, in the most corrupted time, he actually lived out this beautiful life of the law.
他满有怜悯。
He's filled with mercy.
他满有智慧。
He's filled with wisdom.
他珍惜每一个遵守神律法的机会。
He treasured every opportunity to abide by the law of God.
别人找不出任何的瑕疵。
You cannot find any defect.
所预表的正是我们的主耶稣基督。
What this foreshadows is actually our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们的主他完全没有瑕疵，他要成全了律法所有的要求。
Our Lord is perfect, and he is here to complete, to accomplish all that is that the law has intended to do.
而且我们的主他甘心乐意的怜悯和拯救我们，他拯救我们到一个地步，让我们与王子同坐，这是奇异的恩典。
And our Lord Jesus is here willing to save us and save us to a point that we can sit along with the prince. What an amazing grace this is.
第十节这里特别的讲啊，娶了马伦的妻摩亚女子路德为妻。
Here in verse 10, it says that the Ruth the Moabite, the widow of Malon, I have bought to be my wife.
圣灵在讲这个故事的时候，又一次强调路德是摩押女子。
So the Holy Spirit, when the Holy Spirit talks about Ruth, once again mentioned that she's a Moabite.
这里就给我们看到，伯阿斯他不嫌弃路德的出身是摩押人，是从淫乱生的。
Here it shows that Boaz did not mind that Ruth has a background of corruptedness of sinful desires of as a Moabite.
啊，伯阿斯他不嫌弃路德是一个死掉老公的寡妇晦气。
That he did not mind that Ruth is actually a widow of a person that was deceased.
啊，伯阿斯不嫌弃路德是个贫穷的人。
That he did not mind that Ruth is a poor person.
啊，伯阿斯不嫌弃路德在各个方面都配不上他。
That he didn't mind that Ruth, no matter how you compare and look at it, is incomparable to him.
伯阿斯的这个愿意实在是太宝贵了。
So the willingness of Boaz is truly something that's precious.
有时候我们看到两个单身的弟兄姊妹，他们年纪也不小了，我们就觉得这两个人门当户对，我们就试图去撮合。
Sometimes we see two single, a single brother and single sister. They're not young anymore, and they're pretty comparable, and we want to put them together.
我们可以创造一切有利的条件，都不能保证这两个人他们彼此愿意。
We can create all kinds of positive conditions for them, but we still cannot guarantee that the two of them are willing to come together.
然而稀奇的是。我们这么肮脏败坏，一无所有，又常常自以为有的人。
But what's amazing is that for us, people who are corrupted and unclean, and that we have nothing that belong to us.
我们这些曾经与神为仇为敌，常常伤害他的人。
All of us who were once enemies against God, who once really hurt God before.
神却愿意要我们。神却想尽办法来恩待我们。
But God is willing that he wants us, that he has thought of all different ways to come to us.
弟兄姊妹，这个太奇妙了，这是神无条件的爱。
Brothers and sisters, this is truly amazing, and this is the unconditional love of our God.
当神愿意来接纳我们的时候，就意味着他要付出一个代价。
When God is willing to come to accept us,It means that he will be there to pay a price.
在这个故事里面，伯阿斯跟某人最大的不同就是某人不愿意付代价，伯阿斯愿意付代价。
The biggest difference between Boaz and this Mr. So-and-so is that the so-and-so was not willing to pay up a price, and Boaz was willing to.
我们的主他愿意拯救我们。他不是只动一动嘴巴，他是真的为我们付了极重的代价。
Our Lord, for him to be willing to save us, he didn't just pay lip service, he truly went and did the work of salvation.
在新英格兰的一个小镇上，当地的一位传道人有一次他主日讲道的时候，他手里面就提了一个破旧的锈迹斑斑的鸟笼。
So one day there's a preacher in New England, and one day he went to a church, and in a church, right? He was preaching, and he had this bird cage, a small bird cage with him.
他一上台就把这个破鸟笼放到那个讲台上，那弟兄姊妹都惊呆了。你带个破鸟笼来干什么呢？
And this was a rundown, it's a broken bird cage, and he put it in front.Of the stage when he went up to the pulpit to preach, and people were amazed. Why did you bring a broken bird cage to us?
然后这个传道人就给大家讲他这个鸟笼的来历。
So this preacher started to explain the background of this bird cage.
那么他昨天穿过这个小镇的时候，他碰到一个小男孩，他手里就拿着这个破鸟笼，然后有几只这个小鸟就蜷缩在这个笼子里面，瑟瑟发抖，非常的恐惧。
So he said yesterday, as he was passing along the town, he saw this little boy, with this birdcage with birds inside shivering and very scared.
他就问那个小男孩说，孩子呀，你手里拿的是什么？
So he asked this little boy, "Hey, what is it that's in your hand?"
这小男孩告诉他，这就是几只上了年纪的野鸟。
So the little boys told him, "Oh, these are just some old, wild, and old birds."
那传道人就问他，那你打算拿他们来做什么呢？
So the preacher asked the little boy, "What's your plan for them?"
哇，这个小孩子，他就讲我要。 我要把这些鸟带回家呀，好好的来折磨它们。
And this little boy said, "I'm going to bring them home and I'm going to torture them."
我要在它们身上找点乐子，我要把它们搞得精疲力尽，然后再一根一根的拔掉它们的羽毛。
I want to find joy on them. I want to exhaust them, and then I will pick off their feather one by one.
那传道人又问他，那等你。 玩厌了之后，你怎么处理这些小鸟呢？
And the preacher asked, "So after you're done with them, what are you going to do to them?"
这个小男孩就怪笑着给这个传道人讲，你知道吗？我们家还养了好几只小猫，他们可喜欢这些小鸟了。So
the little boy said, "Oh, we have these cats, kittens at home, and they love these small birds."
这个传道人心里面就沉默了一下，就给这个小男孩讲，这样吧。 我想买下这些小鸟，你可不可以卖给我？
So this preacher said to the little boy, "said How about this? I'm willing to buy it. So can you sell it to me?"
这小男孩简直不相信自己的耳朵，他说：“得了吧，你不会喜欢这些小鸟的。你看他们就是普普通通的野鸟啊，他们又老又笨又难看，叫的声音还不好听。”
So this boy was amazed at this because, and he was saying to the preacher, "You don't want these birds. They're old. They're no fun. Their voices are not good even."
这个传道人坚持，就是你开个价。So
this preacher persisted and said, "Just give me a price."
这个小孩就说，那你给我10块钱。So
this little boy said, "Give me $10."
然后这个传道人把钱给他，这个小孩子就非常高兴的扔下鸟笼就跑了。So
this preacher gave him $10, and the little boy went away very happy.
这个传道人就小心翼翼的去提起这个笼子，到一个非常漂亮的公园里面，就把这些鸟儿给放飞了。So
this preacher took up this birdcage and went to a beautiful park and released these birds carefully.
这个传道人他讲完这个鸟笼的来历之后啊，他就讲了另外一个故事。So
after describing the story of this birdcage, this preacher told another story.
有一天啊，这个撒旦从伊甸园里面出来，正好就碰见了耶稣。So
one day Satan came out from the Garden of Eden and he met Jesus.
撒旦手中提了一个以罪和死为栅栏的笼子。 幸灾乐祸地向耶稣炫耀。So
Satan actually had a cage of sin, sin and
death.
Oh, just sin and death, and he was really pleased and to show it to Jesus.
他说：“你看呀，我把全世界的人都抓进这个笼子里了啊！这些人都经不起我的试探和诱惑，通通的掉进了我的陷阱里面。”He
said, "Look." He showed it to Jesus and said, "Look, all the men of this world, they have fallen into the trap of sin, and they have all fell into my lies, and they're all trapped in this cage."
啊，整个世界的人都掉到我的陷阱里面了。And
the people of the entire world have all fallen into the trap.
那耶稣就问他，那您打算把这些人怎么办呢？
So Jesus asked him, "So what are you going to do to them?"
撒旦讲啊，我就拿他们来找点乐子，我要教他们怎么玩弄感情，怎么背弃信义，啊，怎么纵情声色，啊，如何的堕落沉沦。And
Satan basically said, "I'm going to teach them how to deceive each other, how to go against each other, how to just run wild with their desire with one another. I'm going to teach them. I'm going to have them to live in that."
说我还要让他们互相的仇恨，互相的羞辱，还要教他们制造各种 致命的武器，让他们互相残杀，这非常的好玩的。
And I will have them to go against each other. We have them to fight one another to build this weapons of destruction. This is really fun.
那然后呢？耶稣又问他。
Then Jesus asked him again.
撒旦就非常狂妄的笑着，他说：“我最后我要把这些人通通的杀掉。”
Jesus asked them, "What are you going to do them in the end?" And Satan said.I'm going to kill them, kill all of them. And he was saying that with a big laugh.
这个时候耶稣就动了怜悯之心，他就问撒旦说，我想买下这些人，你可不可以开个价？
And now Jesus said, Jesus was moved and he had a heart of mercy and he asked Satan, I want to redeem all this person.Can you give me a price?
这撒旦就嘲笑耶稣，说你得了吧，你不会喜欢这些人的，你看看他们坏透了，他们简直是十恶不赦，忘恩负义。
And Satan said to Jesus and said, you will not want these people. They are really sinful people. They are forgetful. They are not, they don't give thanks to you.
你救他们。你得到的报答只是他们对你的仇恨，只是他们对你的羞辱和唾骂。
You save them, but what you will gain back is only them shaming you, is only them yelling back at you and curse at you.
他们还会把你钉死在十字架上，没有人会愿意救这样的罪人的。
And they will also nail you to the cross. Who will want to save such a person?
耶稣坚持，说我愿意，你开个价。
And Jesus persisted, and he said, I'm willing to. So just give me a price.
撒旦最后讲，你要想让我放他们，你就拿你自己的命来换。他们的赎价就是你的鲜血，你的眼泪和你全部的生命。
And Satan said, if you want to save them, then the price is your own life. If you want to save them, then you need to pay with your own life, with your own blood.Your own tears, and that's the price.
耶稣说我愿意，咱们成交。
And Jesus said, I'm willing to, and that's a deal.
我们的主他也是实实在在付了这样的赎价。
And our Lord, he truly paid up such a price.
所有的救赎都需要救赎者愿意。
All of this salvation needs to have the willingness.
每一个愿意的背后都是一个代价，都是一个筹码。
And that willingness are all carries a price with it.
圣经告诉我们，我们的主耶稣，他把我们从仇敌的手中买赎回来，不是凭着能朽坏的金银，乃是凭着基督的宝血，如同 无瑕疵、无玷污的羔羊之血。
The price that the Bible tells us that.For us to be purchased back by our Lord, for the price that he paid is not the corruptible gold and silver, but he paid with the precious blood, this pure, clean, perfect, and precious blood of himself.
弟兄姊妹们
brothers and sisters,
在这个故事里面，我们是那个已经死在罪恶过犯中的人。
In this story, we are the people who already died in sins and transgressions.
因着神各样奇妙的安排，我们可以存留在神的应许里面。
And because of all the amazing plan and will of God, now we can remain in Him.
在这个故事里面，我们是路德。
In this story, we are Ruth.
我们一无所有，我们原本与神为仇为敌，我们却得到了全宇宙的大君王的爱情。
We have nothing, and we've done nothing, but now we have gained the love from this King of the whole universe.
盼望在神的恩典里面，我们的生命也能够长大，我们也能够越来越像我们的主，我们也能够成为别人的祝福。
How we hope that.In our Lord, we can also grow up, that we may also become other people's blessings.
我们一起低头有点祷告。
Let us pray together.
主，我们实在是谢谢你，因为我们常常忘了你对我们有多好，但是你常常借着你自己的话告诉我们你有多爱我们。
Lord, we thank you because often we have forgotten the grace that you have given us, but you remind us through your words of what you've done for us.
愿你自己恩惠的话语常常成为我们里面的鼓励。
May your gracious words become our encouragement.
好让我们不再为自己活，乃是为那为我们死而复活的主而活。
So that we will no longer live for ourselves, but live for the Lord who died and resurrected.
我们这样的祷告，靠主耶稣基督的名。
We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.